360 degree movement, and this gun, 155mm gun, can fire up to a range of 38 kilometers, which is a quite high. But can this fire also be utilized in a mountainous condition? Can it also be utilized in desert condition? Hello and welcome. My name is Shailesh Kumar and you're watching National Defense. Today, I am joined by someone who is very, very important for this country's defense and security. The director of, rather let him be introduced himself, but I can tell you he is associated with the development of India's top defense manufacturing, the Ordnance Factory Board, which has developed Dhanush artillery gun, 155mm gun. Sir, please introduce yourself.
Good afternoon, everybody. I'm Lokesh Bajpayee, director in ODC GCF and Ordnance Factory Board.
Jabalpur.
And based in Jabalpur, where this gun has been developed. And this 155 and 45 caliber Dhanush gun, as you are seeing behind, is a marvel in the artillery system.
Well, certainly the right word, the marvel. In fact, I should have said that, the marvel in the defense manufacturing. This shows the capability of Indian defense industry, the Ordnance Factory Board, that what sort of system they can develop. And this system can not only be used by India, but can also an item which can be exported. However, this decision is to the government whether they offer it for the export to the friendly nations or not. But let me know about the process behind the development of this gun, how this gun was conceived, because 155mm gun was really needed after we see the Bofors happening long time back, and then the Kargil happened, and we seen that how Bofors was used, and it was so important in winning the war. So thereafter there was a need to have our own 155mm artillery gun, and now the Ordnance Factory Board has developed that gun. Sir, please tell us about the development story of this gun, how the idea was conceived, how it was being initiated, and how much fund was being utilized in this.
This gun has been developed from a long time, and the story began literally from 2011 onwards in a more fast pace. We have developed the mechanical upgrade systems earlier and the electronic upgrade systems, which we were trying to put on the existing Bofors gun systems. But after the seeing the performance of the upgraded system on the existing Bofors gun, the user has accepted to provide us the opportunity for 155 and 45 caliber electronically upgraded gun system, which is being called as Dhanush. And this Dhanush gun system, P414 numbers DAC approval was given and 114 numbers indent was given, which further we have developed, and user exploitation of this gun system has been carried out till date. The development process is an story in itself, long story. We have developed bit by bit, and we have used all the indigenous manufacturing industries, including DPSUs, sale, and build this gun system. All the major components, like major structures, elevating cylinders, and recoil buffers, is being manufactured at GCF only. The ordnance, as you well know, that is being manufactured at OFC and Field Gun Kanpur. So we are going ahead with 81% indigenous content in this gun system, and it is a marvelous gun system, which you can see that it is rotating like 360 degree pivot. It can do in seconds, and also it can hit enemy up to 38 kilometers in its ranges, and its fixation and its orientation capabilities are marvelous due to its INS based system. And it is also having a direct firing capabilities, in which it can hit a target at 1 kilometer easily.
Wonderful 360 degree rotation, as viewers you must have seen yourself, 360 degree movement, and this gun, 155mm gun, can fire up to a range of 38 kilometers, which is quite high. But can this fire also be utilized in a mountainous condition? Can it also be utilized in desert condition? We have seen the demonstration in demo just here in the desert. Sir, tell us whether it can be used in Arunachal Pradesh or maybe in Leh Ladakh, in the mountainous region, in the Kashmir. Can it be?
You will be happy to know that this gun system is made for both desert and high mountains area. This gun has fired more than 4,000 rounds in all different areas, and specifically it has been placed in the Sikkim Menla region, where we have shown the capability of its movement. It has moved there in a very short time, 3 days just. It has been also placed in Leh Ladakh region at 10,500 feet, where it has fired 450 rounds. So there is no point further to prove that this gun is not equipped with.
But Lokeshji, can it also be upgraded? The 38 kilometers, can it also be upgraded to much more range?
Yeah, it can be further upgraded. We are working on one of the projects, which we will come to know over the period. We are also having a 155 and 52 caliber mounted gun systems being displayed in the expo, which you can have a look also, which is having the capability of more than 40 kilometer range.
More than 40 kilometers range, and it is just the beginning that how India, Indian gun guns are really capable of achieving. The enemy must be tattered, the enemy must be threatened, and enemy must remain out of the border. Believe you me, this gun is a silver line solution for India's defense, produced by the OFB. Over 400 guns have been ordered by, cleared by the DAC, Defense Acquisition Council, chaired by the Raksha Mantri, is it?
Yeah.
And there could be orders very soon. When can we have orders from the Indian Army, because Indian Army is the main user?
We are already having the order for manufacturing of 18 guns to be handed over, and we will be doing it shortly. Further guns, as the some of the test user exploitation is on anvil, which will be carried out, and after clearing that, we will be providing the gun system to the user immediately.
Well, that's wonderful. 18 gun systems are already been ordered by the government of India, and there could be many more. It is up to a time that when everyone in the world should understand the capability of India's defense industry, the Ordnance Factory Board and other DPSUs, that we can produce the best defense systems in the world. Salute to all the scientists, all the workers, all the managers and the Indian Army, who is a major force behind the development of this artillery gun. Jai Hind.